Hello everyone, welcome back. We just saw in game one, Rave take down Regal. They put up a pretty strong teamfight performance there. Regal, I think, need to relook at their draft and think how to balance things out a little bit more. They had plenty of heroes to pick people off, chase people down. Bristleback and Viper great at extended teamfights. But Rave came in there, all guns blazing, and there was nothing really Regal could do to counteract that. Let's head on over into the draft and see what's happening. Where Faceless Void, once again, first pickup for Rave with the AA combo. Team pick. They saw it work in game one, and they think, okay, well, we made this happen. Let's do it again. Juggernaut, the first pickup from Regal, after the Vengeful Spirit, Batrider, Naga Siren, and Axe bans. Now, Naga Siren and Axe are banned so often, especially in Southeast Asian Dota. Naga Siren is like first ban, no matter who you're playing against. Axe, though, more of a hero that we saw sprout in the European scene, where people started playing him as that really heavy brawler, blink in, get that blink as quickly as possible, and start jumping in and team fighting, diving behind towers and making things happen.
Reserve time.
Second pick for Regal will be that Skywrath Mage,
Radiant team
comboing up quite nicely with the Juggernaut, and Invoker banned out by Regal, so they're thinking along the same lines I did in game one. What are they going to combo up with this Faceless Void? And I'm thinking you ban out the Troll again. Because the key component in Rave's lineup last game was that Troll Warlord. The Battle Trance with the Chilling Touch and Faceless Void Time Lock. There was so much damage. The Mask of Madness, along with all of that, meant heroes like Batrider, even Bristleback didn't last long in an Aghanim's Chrono. Third ban here for Regal. For Rave, even. It's quite difficult early on in the draft when you're looking up against a Juggernaut Skywrath to know what to ban. Because there are no real overlying strategies that these two heroes play into. Skywrath is a great harassing support, and Juggernaut is a pretty good mid-game carry. So they're going to go with the Brewmaster, a great hero causing chaos, splitting up heroes. I think that's a really good ban. Usually we see it in the first 1-2. It was quite surprising Regal didn't pick it up for themselves. But Brewmaster works so well with Juggernaut. You split up an enemy team, so Jugger can find one or two heroes off to the side, Omni-slash them, and then continue fighting. Troll there, banned out by Regal. Fully agree with that decision. There is no way he should have let that through. Especially after that game one performance from Rave.
10 seconds remaining.
Behold the Horn of Magnus.
Magnus, the third pickup from Rave, definitely going more along the vein of that teamfight-oriented draft.
Team pick.
And Morphling from Regal. So they're going to try and look to outlast Rave, get through these team fights with Healing Ward and Morph to try and keep their cores alive for as long as possible and out-damage this Void. Now, I'm not sure how this Magnus actually works up with the Faceless Void, because you look at the RP and you think, well, you know, the Chronosphere could potentially set that up, but as the Magnus, there's such a fine timing, blinking after a Chrono. So is this an RP before Chrono? Or do they run two different strats here? Do they have the Faceless Void farming while the Magnus goes and makes plays, and then later on they use the Void as that initiator? I think it does give them an added option, but it could lead to quite disjointed teamfights. Rubick again, coupling up with that AA. Pretty nice pickup. Rave did make that work very well for the Ninja Boogie, getting that early Blink Dagger, creating lots of opportunities to steal things like Viper Strike. And now fourth pickup for Regal. Juggernaut, Skywrath, Morphling. They've got some really strong laning potential here. But again, I still feel they're lacking that AoE teamfight. And now they're on the Radiant side, do they still consider going something like an Enigma?
5 seconds remaining.
Need something to try and hold Rave in place. Or at least chase them down. AA and Rubick are quite squishy supports. But we've seen Rave use them really well, getting runes, controlling lanes, and also prioritizing farm on that AA after about 15 minutes. He got that Midas, and he was off on the side lanes farming until he had the Aghanims. Fourth pickup here for Regal. That's what I'm looking for. Dreamquill very good at holding heroes like Magnus in place, so he can't really skewer away or else he'll get stunned. The silence is going to be amazing up against Faceless Void and Magnus, who need to get into melee range before they can start really utilizing their skills. So that gives them the jump potential. get Blink Dagger on Puck, jump in Silence, nuke people down, so then Scarth, Juggernaut, and Morphling
5 seconds
can follow
remaining.
Up and kill people off. Will that be an offlane
Reserve
Puck
time?
Because currently it looks like they've got three cores, Morphling, Puck, and Juggernaut. Safe lane Jug, mid Morphling, Puck offlane. I just feel that they need that Blink Dagger on Puck a lot sooner than an offlane Puck would normally get it. Or it's their plan to sit back for the first 20 minutes, soak up as much of Rave's aggression as they possibly can, and then fight into Rave with the Puck Blink Dagger. Because he should have that by the 20 minute mark. Rave considering what to ban out. Do you ban an offlaner here? Do you ban another support? I think the safest way to go is just to ban a support. Maybe ban a jungler. We are seeing a resurgence of heroes like Chen, things like that, that can apply pressure to towers and give your cores the farm they need. So heroes like Morphling especially, who needs an early burst of gold to really hit his potential, does benefit a lot from heroes like Chen. It is negated quite a bit by the fact that Ancient Apparition is there on the field for Rave. That Ice Blast is very dangerous indeed.
Radiant team.
Storm
ban.
Spirit the ban from Rave. So how are
dire
they looking at this?
Pick.
Do they expect to support Juggernaut here and they've got the Morphling and Pucker's cores? Very interesting ban. I'm not too sure what the reasoning behind that is. Broodmother though, pretty natural fifth ban there. Again, nothing to really deal with those spiderlings. And when you've got heroes like Skyearth Mage, there's no actual way to not die once Brood hits 5.
10 seconds remaining.
You've got to be so good with your positioning and awareness of where the webs are, where
five
he could have spiderlings, how
remaining.
Many spiderlings he has, most importantly, to try and evade those
Reserve
little things.
Time.
Dark Seer.
Oh, wow. So in game
team
1, they
pick.
Went for teamfight. In game 2, they're going full on. Darkseer there picked up. The Vacuum into the Ice Blast, Chrono, RP, whatever you throw at them. And then Rubick, who's going to be stealing spells from Puck and Morphling. There is so much AoE damage from Rave. How does this Darkseer do on the offlane, though? Because that's not going to be an easy lane for him against the Skywrath.
10 seconds remaining.
Regal have to think hard here. How do we dodge these team fights?
Five
How do we make
remaining.
Sure that Rave cannot kill us all? In one fell swoop.
Reserve
Do
time.
They pick something like a Doom? A jungle Doom could possibly work here. Get a blink early on him. Try and aim for the Magnus or the Faceless Void. Even the Darkseer. Just Doom one of these heroes. And that's the big teamfight from Rave out the window. Because they rely on the synergy between all of these skills. I think Darkseer might be the core one there. Because you can vacuum into Chrono, vacuum into RP. So if you Doom him, then they're going to be relying heavily on Regal's positioning. But they go with an Outworld Devourer. So they're not looking for another support. How are they running this Puck then? How are they running this? Because the Vizum on that OD, he was playing the Viper previously. He was their solo safe laner. JNY was the Batrider. So it looks like it might be safe lane OD, offlane Puck. But where do the Juggernaut and Skyrath go? Does Morphling still go mid? Lots and lots of questions I have for these teams. How do you lane this? I think looking at Rave, it's pretty simple. Faceless Void with the AA and Rubick safe lane, get that farm on him. But then they've switched up their players as well.
Remaining.
JO is now the Darkseer. It looks like he won't be playing that mid
Five
role.
5 seconds remaining.
Still have cast on the AA and NB on that Rubick. Let's see how they do this. Juggernaut. Stout Shield, Quelling Blade. He's going to be the safe lane
Time
farmer. Boys,
the
support Morphling. Oh! Is it really? Are we seeing a support Morphling right here? I've heard a lot about it. I've seen lots of theory crafting about it. This is something Ryze from MYM talked about like a year and a half, 2 years ago. Loads of people were saying, look, he's got his 3 second stun. If you max strength, he's got waveform, he's got a nuke, he's tanky, he's ranged. He is an amazing support, theoretically. But I've never seen it really play out. JNY on the offlane puck. OD mid. Support Morphling. I can't wait to see how this works out.
30 seconds.
So that
remaining.
Gives them a stun they were lacking in game one, definitely. Gives them some nuke potential with the waveform. But he needs levels quite desperately, so I wouldn't be surprised to see these two just go and stack and pull the jungle until they hit level 3 or 4. So he definitely needs one level in Morph, so he can go up to strength. And then he needs levels in Adaptive Strike and Waveform, so he's got the nuke and the stun damage. And we're going to see another battle at this top rune. Who's going to get it? Who's going to come out on top? Looks like JNY is instantly dead to Chrissy and Rior. The Morphling finds that bounty rune. Rior the Void still chasing the Morphling down. There's one tango, but there's no way to get an actual kill there. But Rave get one kill. They get the first blood, but the Radiant side get both of those 100-100 bounty runes. JO, 1v1 up against this Juggernaut for now. But we will see the Skyrath and the Morphling head down towards that bot lane, surely. And Chrissy took so much damage from that initial engagement, sitting on 250 HP, close to his bottle, though, so it's not too much of an issue. And then we do have this Faceless Void, protected by his two supports, up on this top lane. JO should have a decent time down here. The only thing he really will worry about is the Skyrath Mage with his harass. Look at that.
Denied.
And then Cloud with the Quelling Blade can take down his Ion Shell creeps relatively quickly. So they have got a way of clearing JO's Ion Shell. It's just the amount of harass that comes out before they clear it. That's the issue for them. JO, nice work there, cancelling that pretty fresh clarity, in fact.
Dire's courier was lost in battle.
Oh dear. Sneaky Morphling. Looping around. Unfortunately, not getting Magnus's bottle, but nevertheless, finding a kill on that courier. Plenty of gold for him. Waveform over the cliff. And he's going to be fine. So a nice bit of gold there in their pockets. If that had Magnus's bottle on, he would be absolutely livid. JO here. Look how annoying that is for Cloud. He's got to run away from these Iron Shell creeps. He does have Healing Ward and Blade Fury to deal with it, as well as that Quelling Blade I mentioned, so it's not too much of a hassle. It's just that he might miss out on last hits. JO gets that rune down on bot lane, regenerating for him, pretty good. If only he had a bottle to go with it. 11 for 6 on the OD, 10 for 5 on the Juggernaut, so overall they're winning the last hit battle on the Radiant. They've got slightly superior lanes. Even after that first blood, the Puck is level 2.5, doing absolutely fine up here. And harassing this Faceless Void. Poor Man Shield is up on him. But this is what we're seeing from Rave. Stacking the camps as much as possible. Try and get experience and gold on these supports by stacking and pulling these camps here. And then give an opportunity for the Magnus and possibly the Darkseer to farm these camps. So there we see the AA pulling through to the large camp. JNY, he knows it's happening, so he'll try and contest this. Get some hits in on Cast, who does have to be careful up against a level 2 Illusory Orb. Can Puck get that last hit? No, he can't. The Dark Troll Summoner creating skeletons. Not getting that hit in he expected. Ooh, missing out on the stack there. Nope, gets it. Very nice. Very nice indeed. So I'm guessing this is for the Darkseer. Not sure what kind of build Darkseer is going to go for, though. Does Darkseer... Yeah, Bottle. I like that. I think that's a good option for him since the rune changes. He can just surge over to that rune, fill up his bottle. But after that, what does he go for? Do you still go for the Soul Ring? I don't feel it's entirely necessary with the bottle. Arcane Boots, possibly. Arcane is into Mech, then Blink Dagger. I think that's a really nice build for him. Rave are going to have so many opportunities to initiate when they've got Blink on Darkseer, Blink on Magnus, the Time Warp from the Void, Ancient Apparition Ice Blast. OD looking to dominate this lane up against Magnus. Mag will get that top rune. As long as OD... Oh, he's got Astral. There is no way Magnus is getting this rune, actually. Astral, my rune, see ya. They could possibly go for a kill here. There's no mana on the Magnus, though. 39 mana. He does have some now, and in comes Ninja Boogie. Telekinesis. Do they need the skewer? Do they need the shockwave? Shockwave is used, and Morphling looking to create a fight. But not really the position you want to be in when there are three heroes from Rave all here defending that Magnus. OD gets the illusion rune, but loses his life as a result. This leaves the Puck 1v1 up against this Void. So Puck getting a few more last hits in, but Void definitely catching up with the Juggernaut. J.O. looping back into the jungle here, looking for a bit more gold to add to his little coffers. And this is somewhere the Skyrath can't really harass him out. In fact, does J.O. find a kill here on the Skyrath? Iron Shell, Surge, considering it, the level 2 Iron Shell and level 2 Surge might be able to give him a kill. There we go, he goes for it. Concussive Shot not going to help you out, Skyrath. That Surge from the Darkseer going to allow him to continue chasing. No, he jukes through the trees. The Skyrath is away. J.O. getting outplayed there by CK. Expecting him to go back this way towards the mid lane, maybe to get help from the rest of his team. But instead, looping around and finding a route to escape. Puck not really in too much trouble on top lane unless Rubik's around, because there's no stun or silence really unless Void gets a lucky time lock. And where is that Rubik? Down on bot lane looking for some golden experience. They're very good at doing this, switching a support round, not necessarily to find a kill or an opening, just to give him some experience and gold. If there's no one else on that lane, why not? Juggernaut is nearly level 6 though, so he does have to be wary of the Omnislash. Faces Void, finds a kill on Puck, but OD here. Astral onto the Magnus. You can't get runes against the OD. So difficult. The Chronosphere was used up against Puck, so that's a way they can take him down. I was saying there's no stuns or silences, but once Void hits 6, that's game over for Puck.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He's still 9 last hits behind that jug. But how are we looking for hero level? The supports on the Radiant are pretty low on level, but that's made up by the fact that their cores are leading the charts.
Double damage.
But as always, Rave making full use of their support, stacking and pulling, getting experience where they can. And now J.O. does go for that Soul Ring after the bottle, give him that extra bit of mana, allow him to farm these camps without expending too much. And that's easy, easy gold for him. Astral onto the Magnus. Magnus is having such a rough time here. I think he just skips all items after this and goes straight for Blink. There's no real way to get that Blink if you delay it even further and go for Arcanes or Treads or Magic Stick or anything like that. But it's so annoying dealing against this Astral Imprisonment from the OD. There's now nobody on this bot lane, so the push can commence.
Dire's bottom tower is in turmoil.
We might see a TP from the Void though, once that Chronosphere is ready to go. But in fact, we see a TP from the Skyrath up to this top lane.
Dire's bottom tower is on its way further down.
Can they make a go on this Void? He doesn't have boots. He's got 760 HP, so Dream Coil, level 3 orb, plus Skyrath, Silence, and orb. Oh, they're going to find the AA. Much easier target. Definitely no route for escape there. Mask of Mana is picked up by the Jug, slightly after the Void. That's a very early level in Wall, actually. No Vacuum, going for a 0-4-2-1 build. But it gets him a kill. The Magnus does go for those Arcane Boots, so he will be delaying that Blink Dagger by another, what, 5-6 minutes? Well, that's going to come down to whether his teammates stack the jungle for him and he can take the gold from those jungle camps. Then we look at JNY, who's about 1,000 gold away from his Blink Dagger. He's done well for himself up on the top lane.
Is in turmoil.
Not being stopped as much as I thought he might be. Now the move into the Dire supports. Cast and Ninja Boogie. Both desperately trying to ward and deward. Really nice there. Realizing they need to start taking control of this map. Making things happen.
Their structures.
Yeah, the Magnus will start stacking and pulling for himself. Well, stacking for himself so he can get a bit more gold income, which he desperately needs. Void pushes out the lane, goes into the jungle, farms up, and then we'll head back to that lane. He does have Chrono. when he has the mana for it. Clarity might need to get used here. But I think he wants the Time Walk and Chrono. You need some way to catch out that puck.
Not yours.
Still not seen the strength of this support morphling quite yet. But he has not yet maxed out his strength. He's still keeping it about half and half. Chronosphere onto the puck though. Mask of Madness, Agi treads. Puck is dead.
This changes nothing.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
attack. And there's an Astral. Up he. Slightly mistimed. Astral Imprisonment onto the Magnus. Silent stuff. Not sure they can kill him though. He's got plenty of HP. So, that RP. He tried. He was close. He tried to get the OD
Radiant's
from here by turning this way
guests.
To get the RP to actually bring him to this position here. So they could kill him. Close but no cigar. OD finishes up a Midas, that's on the way, and Jo actually got a Midas of his own. So going for the Bone 7 school of thought. I've got gold, let's spend it on things which can give me more gold. But I think more importantly, for Darkseer definitely, it's about hitting level 11 and 12. Getting 4 up into Vacuum, especially because you've gone for 4 in Iron Shell and 3 in Surge. You need another 4 levels in fact, so it's going to be level 13. Before he can have max vacuum and level 2 wall. And he's going to die here to that Juggernaut Omni Slash. Concussive shot. Ooh, oh, the Ion Shell finishing him off. Ninja Boogie with that Fade Bolt. Going to have to back up here. What does he steal? Steals Omni Slash. That's an okay spell, I guess. Might die to crits from Cloud, but not quite lucky enough. Gets a couple in there. That Juggernaut has plenty of gold to play with. Goes for the Yasha after the Mask of Madness, just stacking up that attack speed. Get as many hits and crits as you can during Omni Slash is pretty much the way to go with the new Jugger. Chilling Touch, Mask of Madness onto Puck. Silence, but one more hit from AA. Takes him out of the game. And how are we looking for Chrissy now? 800 gold away from that Blink Dagger. Just regenning up, farming the jungle. Can't really go to lane up against the OD because he's such a pesk. Such a nuisance.
Dire's middle tower is under fire.
Cloud might be caught out here. Ninja Boogie and Jo both looking for an opening up to Cloud. Telekinesis, Fade Bolt. Can't get it off in time. They do have the Omni Slash on the Rubick though, dealing quite a bit of damage to Cloud. Healing Ward gets dropped. There goes the Wall of Replica from that Darkseer, but the crits turn around onto the Rubick. They don't even get the kill on the Juggernaut. And Jo stuck in the Mystic Flare. Walks into the Roche Pit, trying to deny himself to Mr. Roshan. Uses Surge to get out. He actually gets out. Morphling doesn't use Adaptive Strike, so can't get the kill.
Top tower is under attack.
What a play from Jo though, running in here. Looping back around, using Surge to actually get out of there. But nevertheless, not killing that Juggernaut. The main reason they went in, they lost the Rubick, but couldn't get the kill on that key hero. Ice Blast landing on 2. The Morphling and that OD in a bit of trouble. One more Shockwave. Does it land? Doesn't quite. The OD is going to survive. Didn't really need to Astral himself, but it's always better safe than sorry. And now we're looking at 300 gold until Blink Dagger for the Magnus. He's got a nice regen room there. Get some more Shockwaves off. Go into the jungle. Farm up. Void takes down the tier 1 tower on top lane, but Huck. With that 13-minute Blink Dagger pickup, may prove to be crucial for Regal in coming back into this game. And I say coming back, just looking at the Void and the Darkseer, they're slowly amping up their teamfight potential. Maelstrom, Mask of Madness pretty much done for Rior on the Void. And then the Darkseer, once he's got a few more levels, he'll have that level 4 vacuum, level 2 wall. So the next 5-6 minutes are definitely key for Regal to find kills. Utilize that Puck Blink Dagger. But we're going to see a Blink Dagger timing for Magnus there. Yep. And there's a Midas recipe, I'm guessing, for the AA. Dropping all the things. What are you dropping all the stuff on the floor? They belong to people. Chrissy might be the target of choice here. OD going to try and Astral him, but can't quite get in range. Again, why?
Radiant's bottom tower has
just notifying his team in that bounty rune. Morphling has a bottle. Yeah, there we go. Give some mana to that puck. I think Void's wondering the same. Whose Midas recipe is this, and why haven't you picked it up yet? But Cass doesn't quite have the Gloves of Haste yet. Needs a few more gold. Now, does Jao skip mech completely here and go straight for Blink Dagger? I think it's definitely an option for him. Where they blink the Darkseer forward and then blink the Magnus on top of the Vacuum. Mask of Madness. Used by the Juggernaut, finds Cass. He gets the Ice Blast off, which is, you know, that's his job pretty much. But there's no real reaction there from Chrissy. The rest of the team just a little bit too far away. And this Radiant Ward is spotting everything out. They know where the Rubick is. And you've got to be wondering, why is the Rubick here, walking backwards and forwards? Dire Observer Ward sees the Skyrath Mage, and he is going to be an easy, easy target. Places the sentry, which doesn't quite see that observer.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Silence from the puck, jumps in Illusory Orb, going across. Ninja Boogie looking for the kill. Astral Imprisonment onto the Skyrath, not allowing him to die. And then Radiant's the Wall Vacuum. Tower has uninvited not quite guests. Hitting. Ice Blast thrown. Not hitting either. Oh, Rave. Everything was so close, but not quite. They still have that RP. They still have Void Chronosphere. So they do have tools at their disposal to take a team fight. I think they've just got to be a little bit more careful in how they're throwing these spells around.
Dire's middle tower is in the wrong end of business.
Because when you're dealing with Puck and Morphling, Juggernaut, heroes that can basically take themselves out of a team fight and then come back in very quickly. Omni Slash, Illusory Orb, Phase Shift, Waveform, Replicate, you've got plenty of ways to dodge these big team fight ultimates.
Dire has secured their structures.
Juggernaut has a Blink Dagger, but so does
Radiant's
that Darkseer.
Tower is under attack.
Dire's they've got Vacuum. Is under fire. Wall in 45 seconds. RP still ready. They're going to kill that replica because they thought it was the real one. Oh, what a tragedy. They're missing spells left, right, and center here. Nothing's hitting for them. Void going to get taken out by the OD. Sanny's Eclipse killing him during the Astral. Jao in a lot of trouble here. Ancient Apparition has already gone down. Mystic Flare. And then the Orb from the OD finishing him off. Ninja Boogie TPing out just about. But Chrissy finding one kill. He got something. Not worth it. But at least it was something. And now Chrissy can't blink out. Another 1 second cooldown left on there. Gets silenced to death. And OD finds a triple kill. And 1500 gold after that engagement. But I can't believe they missed almost every single
Dire's
spell once again.
End of business. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Ice Blast hits the puck. But it's not gonna kill him. Ancients have been stacked once and Roshan has not been touched yet. I think this might be something for Regal this game. They've got the opportunity to go in there and kill Roshan with heroes like Juggernaut. But when you're up against these big teamfight ultimates, it's always a little bit scary. So maybe they go for a pickoff, push the tier 2 here, have a teamfight. Definitely ward up, though. That is the key thing, really. When you're pushing this tier 2 to secure Roshan, you need to ward up. Experience-wise, that teamfight gave a pretty big swing of experience over to Regal. 3,000 lead for Rave before that. Gold-wise, same story. 1,500 lead swings to a 2,000 lead in net worth for Regal. So not a massive change, but a change nonetheless. Gives them a nice boost of gold. Gives them the opportunity to possibly think about smoking up, finding more pickoffs, and diminishing the strength of Rave's teamfights. Jao can get caught here by an Astral Imprisonment. But he can always blink out. How's his Rubick doing? No Blink Dagger for him this game. He is pretty damn poor. Look at this Morphling, 1500 HP. No damage to speak of, but that all comes from this. Adaptive Strike, Waveform. He is all about the disable, really. And here we go, this is what I was looking for. Win a team fight, a minute later, go and smoke. Try and assert your dominance even further. Rior, not going to get caught here. They turn right, they go up the cliff. Observer Ward placed there. They see these camps have been taken. Are they going to walk into the AA? The AA has finished his Midas. He's not too bothered about dying here right now. He's got the Gloves of Haste on the courier. Yellow signals out the Void, who's making a BKB, desperately needs some way of dealing with the magic damage and spells coming out from Regal. RP, very nice from Chrissy. Skewer back into the Darkseer and the Rubik. That's a big kill for them. They lose the AA in their own jungle, and the Void escaping there. Not going to lose the Void, but they killed the Juggernaut. I've got to say, beautiful play from Chrissy there. Placing himself so he RPs and then turns himself around. So the Juggernaut gets placed here. And then skewers him back to the rest of his team.
Isn't well at the moment.
Morphling Blink Dagger. Something I think we saw from Syla about 8 months ago or so. Going for the Morphling Blink, but he was still playing Carry Blink. Carry Morph. Quite interesting to see on a support morph who's got Arcane Boots and Bottle along with that Blink Dagger. Vacuum is used. Not going to catch anyone though. The Puck, too slippery, evading all of that. Getting away. Four staff being built up by that Magnus. Just trying to keep these lanes pushed out. We see 4,000 gold on that OD. BKB, I think, is a pretty big item for him. Hex might be better though. What's going on up here? JL gets caught out by that Morphling stun. The Adaptive Strike locking him in place for 3 seconds. And the DD Morphling doing 70 damage. Not really hitting too hard. And Ninja Boogie's just going to try and get the heck out of dodge. The crits from the Mask of Madness Juggernaut, too much to deal with though. Puck did not jaunt to that orb. Chrissy might be able to find a kill here. Doesn't have Blink yet. Waiting for the phase shift. Trying to bait it out. But thinks better of it. Doesn't know where the rest of the Radiant team are. And they really want to get that BKB up on that Void before they take a next team fight. So Darkseer, Midas, Blink, 1500 gold. Probably going for a Shiva's or something like that as his next item. Just try and tank up as much as you can. But there we saw the strength of that Morphling. Blinking in, initiating with that Adaptive Strike. That long duration stun. Astral Imprisonment onto the Void. And that's a Time Walk away and TP out. Is there a stun? Yes, there is from the Omni Slash. The mini stun there, cancelling the TP.
I'll feed you for your death mask now.
Skyrath moving back to defend this tier 1. There's no real way for Rave to make waves and push out into Regal's area. This whole area here is difficult for Rave to actually get into because of the mobility of Puck and Morphling. Always the threat of their stuns and silences. The Astral Imprisonment from the OD. But we do have the AA with Midas. He's coming back into this. The thing is, with Rave's teamfight composition, they get one cycle of their ultimates off correctly, and Regal are dead. So Regal have to be constantly aware of where they're going, where they're positioning their heroes. Don't group up more than two heroes in one place, or else you're going to get vacuumed, RP'd, chrono to death. But if Regal continue playing like they are, and they're finding pickoffs, they're taking teamfights very well, they keep their warding up in the dire jungle so they can always scout people out. Then this game shouldn't be too difficult for them. They've got the elusiveness of these heroes to be able to take team fights as long as they keep their wits about them.
Dire's top tower is not on top of things. Radiant's middle tower is not safe.
I think it might be rush time now for the Dire.
Dire's top tower is
And they definitely
attack.
Have the ultimates to secure this Roshan. If Regal ever want to try and contest.
Dire's top tower isn't well at the moment.
BKB finally down on that Void. That kill on top lane really did set him back by quite a bit. And here we see the ODs. He's invis'd up. Orb does fly across. They haven't taken Rosh yet. Void is a very low on HP. Uses BKB. Does have Chrono, has Time Walk as well. Gonna have to Time Walk into Chrono. Someone catches two, in fact. Finds the Skyrath and the Puck. Nice damage there onto the Radiant side. Regal looking like they're in a bit of trouble, but they find the two supports in the back end of play. They and Rubik have both died. JO caught between a rock and a hard place. The wall gets thrown down. The illusions killing the Morphling. But he manages to waveform out. And now we're left with Chrissy, has RP. Rior on that Faceless Void is ready to go. Finds a DD. The RP on two. The damage is real. Can they kill the Juggernaut as well? Looks like they can with a skewer back and Rior getting that double damage rune. Absolutely key in finding those kills. Lifestealing back, staying on about 100 HP. If he hadn't had that DD, he was dead for sure. What a massive turnaround there. It looked like Regal had that in the bag. But the RP held by Chrissy. The Faceless Void, time walking down to catch that double damage rune, the RP on two, the Juggernaut not able to react in time. No Omni Slash, no abilities to save his teammates. And these two heroes come out on top. And this is the thing, they don't need all of their ultimates to turn a team fight around. Even if they've just got two heroes left, they can kill Regal pretty easily. Empower on Void with the Vacuum Chrono. Big stuff. J.O. went for Boots of Travel, didn't go for that Shiva's quite yet. Wants to be a little bit more mobile across the map, split push these lanes out. Because that is something they're quite susceptible to, is getting picked off in their jungle, and then the Radiant pushing out lanes. Puck, Skyrath, and Morphling here looking for something. They find the Void. They see him. There's the stun. 3 seconds on him. Mystic Flare, Silence Orb, dead. Aegis the Immortal will allow him to respawn. But how do you react to that? Morphling blinks forward, adaptive strikes you, so you're stunned for 3 seconds on a non-ultimate skill. It is 3 seconds, right? I just have to... Stun minimum, stun max, 4.25 seconds on a non-ultimate skill is absolutely ridiculous. You cannot react in time. Void looking for payback. Gonna BKB through the silence. Doesn't have time walk left. The TP from the Skyrath. Can he get a lucky bash? No, not quite. Nearly kills him though without it. JO late on the vacuum. And Cloud hiding in the trees here. 4 seconds until his TP comes off cooldown. Just gonna make a run for it. Looks like he's going for an Abyssal Blade. But yeah, 4.25 seconds stun. You have to try and BKB your blink or something during the projectile travel time from the adaptive strike, or else you're dead. Because then you've got Puck jumping in and nuking you, silencing you. Skyrath Mage, that Mystic Flare. How long does it last, actually? Duration, 2.4 seconds. So half of the duration of that stun. You get a full Mystic Flare on you. Ice Blast, the trail hitting that OD. And J.O. once again is pushing out these lanes, trying to put the onus onto Regal to make something happen. So they know if Regal go to them and are forced to push out of their base, if they gather around a tier 2 tower, that's where Rave can actually make things happen. So it's kind of reverse psychology. They're pushing out these lanes, making Regal think that they're desperate, but they're just farming. Rave are just farming these lanes, pushing them out. So the natural reaction then, like... If someone, let's say in football, if someone slaps you on the chest, you're defending a corner, someone slaps you on the chest and starts running, your natural reaction is to chase after them. But it's just a bait. They're pushing these lanes out, so Regal push them back and go up towards these tier 2 towers. So they can find team fights, but J.O. wants to farm a little bit too long, and there's that long, long stun from the Morphling. Ninja Boogie on the Rubik. Hiding away in the trees here. Not going to look for any kind of kill. Or counter move. Smoked RP up on the Cloud. Chronosphere and death shortly follows. Two ultimates used for the Juggernaut, but that's a big kill for them. Rubik does die in the end, gets found out, I guess, or tries to escape from their little cubbyhole he found for himself. But now, how do the Dire defend their tier 2? They've used their Chrono and the RP, their big teamfight ultis, to get one kill. A big kill, sure. But now they have to resort to letting tier 2 fall.
Dire's top tower is not on top of things. Dire's top tower has fallen.
AA, trying to make that Aghanim's up, gonna stack this ancient camp for his Faceless Void. And Void's gonna head up to top lane, farm up that creep wave which has been pushed in. Let's take a quick look at how things are going. So yeah, the game has definitely balanced itself out quite a lot. Net worth, almost nothing in it at all. Experience-wise, same story. 2,000 lead to Rave now. Swings and roundabouts in these team fights. The early game, Rave missed a lot of their ultimates, but they're definitely bringing it back. And they've always got that opportunity to swing a teamfight around completely. Even if Regal play everything perfectly, Rave always have that ace in the hole where they can RP a couple of heroes. The Empowered Void. What kind of items are we looking at for him now? MKB got picked up not long ago, keeping that Maelstrom as it is, not Mjolnir. Juggernaut. Facing off against this Dyer's Magnus.
Middle tower is under fire.
And the rest of his team is coming in. Morphling buys a gem, going to look to try and deward as much as he can. Chrissy blinks into the trees. Morphling, do you know where he is? They don't. Orb just a little bit too late. Magnus has already TP'd out. And RP is back off cooldown. So is Chronosphere. Is now the time they start looking for teamfights? Or do they want to wait for a refresher on Mag? I don't think that's really an item they desperately need. It's nice to have it just in case things go wrong. But you don't need that ultimate refresh to win these teamfights. J.O. waiting in the wings. Has a Mystic Staff. I don't know if that's going to be Shiva's or Hex. I think I said Shiva's earlier because that would have been nice. But Hex at this point in the game when you're up against a Juggernaut like this would be definitely Dyer's good.
Bottom tower is on its
and you don't
way
want to rely too heavily on AoE. You want some kind of single target just to lock someone down and open up opportunities for you in these teamfights. They're going for it. OD is not a part of this fight. He wants to try and farm up top lane, maybe find a pickoff up there. But five men from Rave are going to be going head to head against four from Regal. Will we see the strength of the five-man teamfight composition from Rave? It looks like they're just backing off, giving up. Ninja Boogie. Not sure what was going on there, but he TP's down to join the rest of his team. The rest of his team just back up. Do they have a smoke of their own? Can they go into the Radiant Jungle to try and find something? Looks like they don't want to. That would have been a perfect time to fight, but they didn't know Regal are smoked up and were going for that tier 2 dive, pretty much. They want to allow Regal to come to them. Rave don't want to be the aggressors, really. They want to react to what Regal are doing.
Dyer's bottom tower is in turmoil.
Cast, nice dewarding there, just keeping control of their own jungle as much as they possibly can, because they know, I've been saying it for the past Dyer's 20 minutes or so, if Morphling and Puck go into this jungle and find pretty much anyone, they're dead. 10 million second stun from the Morphling.
Dyer's bottom tower is
Puck is making an agonist. We'll soon see what J.O. decides to do with that Mystic Staff, whether it is a Hex or a Shiva's. And we're not too far away from Refresher Orb on that Magnus now. Doesn't need too much more gold. Hex then Shiva's on the OD. He is looking pretty damn farmed. Only 700 gold behind that Void, who has been given priority 1 farm for the entirety of the game. And then they've got Juggernaut not too far behind on about 15k himself. He does want to finish that Abyssal Blade as quickly as he possibly can. Just to try and lock down his Void, if anything. Ice Plant's going to land on Puck. Do they have the rest of the damage to actually take him down, though? Doesn't look like they can. Chronosphere going to get thrown out. Where's the Puck? Where's he hiding? They do get the kill. The BKB used on the Void. Morphling going to try and find some kind of counter kill here. But I'm not sure they can. Void has Time Walk in 1 second. Gets the 4.5 second stun off. Waveform Surge onto that Void. The Mystic Flare taking him down to about a third of his HP. Cloud coming in. Can't get the Omni Slash quite. The movement speed on Rior from the Surge. Just enough to get him out of range. The waveform across, the mask matters from Cloud. They're still going for this. They get the Omni Slash, they get the Blink, the RP onto one. Only catching a Morphling. The Ice Blast not hitting anyone at all. Chrissy in a lot of trouble here. Going to be caught out by Cloud. Refreshes, Omni Slash hitting creeps. Can he get the RP off on two? Cannot get it off. And now Ninja Boogie puts himself on the front line. This Morphling blinks forward again. 4.5 seconds stun. Cloud, mask of madness on. Crits for days. Rubick not standing a chance. Suddenly triple kill for that Juggernaut out of nowhere. Team Regal blinking forward, being the aggressors, finding Rave completely out of position. The Void went for the kill on the Puck, great. But if you then give up 3 deaths for that 1 kill, not worth it. OD finding a nice little team fight here up against Jo and Rior. And that Void had just bought back, didn't he? Void bought back and nearly died straight afterwards. First lane of Rax going down here for Regal. No Glyph of Fortification. No spells to counteract this. There is no way to defend this lane of Rax. Do they go for more? It looks like they're perfectly happy going for this tier 2 and maybe pushing in more. The RP was refreshed by the Magnus, so that will be available when he respawns in about 5 seconds time.
Dire's middle tower is lost.
And Roshan, not long until he respawns. Radiant are going to get there a little bit too quickly though. I think they should farm Ancients first. And then go scout Roshan out.
I'll take that as tribute.
How long is that? Another 30 seconds or so? That's an interesting buyback from Darkseer. They want to go and defend Roshan right now, but he's not alive yet! JNY on that puck, finishes his Aghanims. And that Abyssal Blade is done for Cloud. You can see a smoke here from the Dire side. Roshan respawns as they smoke up. Do they take this themselves? It looks like that might be an opportunity for them. The Radiant aren't going back in there. They want to go straight into the Rosh pit. Do they scout it out first, expecting they're in there? Does he time walk in? Just Void, he just walks in. Well, that's a free Roshan. The Radiant are posturing, getting ready to go back in. But where's their OD? He's so far away. Orb flies across, scouts it out. Not going to jaunt to that. In comes the stun from the Morphling. RP only catching one. Juggernaut has already blinked forward and Omni slashed the Void to death. Ninja Boogie gets caught, but the Ice Blast hits two. Mystic Flare flying out onto the Magnus, and they've got nothing left. The Void and the Mag are dead. The Rubik falls shortly after. Jo puts the wall down, but can't get anyone in it. This is going to be Roshan for the Radiant. Triple kill for the Skyrath Mage, in fact. Regal coming out on top. Simply because of that Juggernaut blink. Doesn't get caught in the RP here. Blinks forward. Gets the Omni Slash onto the Void, who can't buy back. They've got no ultimates left. And this looks like it might be game. Regal pushing down both lanes. They want to try and take both sets of racks before the Void and Magnus can respawn. And it looks like that's just what they'll do. Ice Blast going to hit the Juggernaut, but he doesn't really care. He is perfectly happy turning on Master of Madness, going straight for the racks. GG called. Yeah, there is no way to defend this. Regal Gaming take game two. Rave did play a little bit slopwell. They played really sloppily. Missing a lot of their ultimates, sort of 15 to 25 minutes into the game. But Regal proving that they are strong enough drafting-wise. I think this was very good from them. Laning-wise, drafting-wise, they played very well. Whenever they took a team fight, they'd then go and smoke and find a counter kill somewhere. But overall, very nicely done from Regal, taking game two in this best of three series. Now it's all down to game three. Who gets that spot in Division 1 in the joint Dota League Asia? And who goes down to the lower bracket to continue fighting for that spot? We'll find out shortly.